gentlemen, welcome to the Ross Patterson Revolution!
Okay, welcome.
We're back.
We're back from the city of angels, the land of lights, the city of rubies, the mudslide bonanza, the city of stars, superstars. A lot of big celebrities on the show.
Huge celebrities.
But now we're back.
We're back in Wilmington. We're back in the groove.
Yeah, we're here.
I'm back. Which a lot of people were really, I got one or two different emails.
Full emails?
Full emails that said, where were you?
Right.
We're not going to watch if you're not on it.
Yeah.
Jim O'Hare, Parks and Rec, what?
Sure.
You know, so.
Yeah. And there was a bunch of faxes. A lot of people don't know this. You have a fax machine in your bedroom, and one or two faxes that came through.
One was
for a Carnival cruise. A Norwegian Carnival cruise, which was a nice thing. And that was a special offer. You had won something. Apparently, you were drawn at random and you had won it. You'd won this cruise. And then the second one, I think, was hey, are you on the show?
Yeah, but I don't know. It looked like it was to me.
But I think it was in Braille. So I'm not sure.
Why do we keep the facts in our room?
Yeah, you keep
That's
the facts
really
next year, but I don't know. Why do you even have a fax machine? You know?
What is there any other way to receive correspondence?
Well, courier pigeon's real hot. I keep leaving the window open for you.
No, I've way moved on.
Okay.
I don't use it that much anymore.
All right, well, look.
I'm definitely into the fax now. I'm into the 20th.
You're done cupping?
Is that what happens?
That's what happens.
Okay.
Flipping pigeons on the roof.
Oh.
That's what happens. Boys in the hood, training day.
Obviously, I know that.
Yeah, the cops are coming. Boom, flip those pigeons.
Oh.
Yeah, you got to, that alerts everyone. Popo's in the neighborhood. Pigeons are flying. We need to move our drugs. We got to move our weed. Everybody grab your shit. The cops is in the neighborhood.
With the shoes hanging on
the whole thing on the telephone pole. Yeah,
I don't want to go too deep into the drug culture. We will go
way off the rails.
Onto a drug tangent.
Way off the rails. And we're not here for that today. Because today we're going to be on the rails. Specifically on the wings today. I am fucking hot today. I am real goddamn hot today over this United Airlines thing.
You really are. Like,
boy.
I'm not scared, but it's like, a little bit.
Well, because it happened to me.
Yeah. No, you're definitely like, this is a stance that you're taking.
This happened to me. And, you know, we got some sponsors who will get to.
Yeah, we'll get into it.
And I definitely want to get into this because it's not, I don't want people to think at home who've seen the story over the last 24 hours of like, oh, just a random, you know, Chinese man.
No.
In his 60s, they've thrown off the plane.
This is happening
to normal people. And this happened to me. Like, I'm not a normal person.
Yeah.
One would think that this wouldn't happen to me, and it did.
Yeah.
And I raged against the fucking machine.
Yes.
I had a pocket full of shells I went up to the counter.
I know, let's calm down. But listen, I wanted to talk about the Duran Duran episode,
too. Tomorrow night, we have Duran Duran on the audio show. It's an audio-only show. They would not allow us to do video, shockingly.
Well.
You know?
You were sitting next to him.
I know. I was sitting next to him, and they said no video. They didn't want to incriminate themselves, I guess. I don't know. Maybe not.
I don't know.
Did I ask him a couple questions that made him uncomfortable? Maybe. Maybe
listen,
I did.
Listen, you did it for the people. You knew
it's
that
things,
the audience wanted.
Yes, I'll say it's things we've talked about on the show before.
Yes.
And either way, super stoked that Duran Duran's on the show. The Jablers got to go down to the press pit, take some
super
pictures.
Fun.
So it was fucking awesome. We'll post those on a Ross Patterson Revolution Facebook page and Instagram coming up tomorrow.
So it's coming out tomorrow.
Tomorrow night, 8 p.m. EST.
It's a good one.
It's a good one. It's a fun one. It was some bucket list type shit. I can't believe it happened. But anyways, we got some sponsors who pay for this to be on the air. First up, kids, look, there's a reason why My face is so baby face fresh every single day. And that's because of straightrazors.com. Best in the biz, kids. They've got the number one ranked aftershave, cologne. They've got shampoo, beard oil, conditioners, and their straight razors are the jam. Everybody's like, dude, how do you eternally never age? You look like Pharrell. And I'm like, it's just a nice fucking shave. Nice goddamn shave. Every day online is like, Jesus, ever since you shaved that mustache, you look 25. But I will say this. A lot of people said, we miss you with the mustache.
Really?
Yeah. They said they preferred the mustache, which I get it. Look, if there's a man who can rock a fine stash, it's me. But guess what I used to edge that bitch up every day? Straightrazors.com. Here's the thing, kids. If you go to straightrazors.com and get one of these kits, throw it up on the counter, and your lady doesn't give you the beej of your life, call me and we'll chat about it.
You're giving guarantees?
I'm gonna give a guarantee that if you put straightrazors.com, if you put the whole kit out on your bathroom sink, and a stranger comes in, a strange lady, a one night stand, if you will, comes in, she doesn't give you the beej of your life after seeing that, hit me up and we'll chat about it.
Let me be clear about this guarantee.
Yeah.
And you're giving guarantees.
I'm giving guarantees.
So you're saying it has to be a stranger?
No, I'm not saying a stranger
So if you get straight razor, you buy it.
Yeah. I was going to say under a 6-month relationship, but I'll go further. Let's say you've never had some shit like this before.
Okay.
And you've been dating somebody for a long time or married for a long time, and then you pop up with this, they're gonna think you're cheating on him. They're going to be like, does he have a side piece?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Who is his fucking side piece? Okay. Who is this side bitch that I need to be concerned about? Like, who just shows up with brand new shaving shit? You can be like, nah, listen to the Ross Patterson Revolution. It's the dope shit.
Right.
He told me the jam. Go to straightrazors.com. Type in the promo code REVOLUTION. You get 20% off. I'm making that guarantee. Next up, we got strikeforceenergy.com. Boy, on a show like this where I am hot and I need a little extra energy, I'm going straight from the bottle today, kids. Boom,
oh
boom.
Oh, my gosh. Do you need to be more hot?
Boom, boom.
I don't know. I don't know.
Should I be? Legally
sure.
Not, but I'm going to be.
Yeah. Mm. No, I hear you.
Go to strikeforceenergy.com. Type in the promo code REVOLUTION. You get 20% off. Look, kids, they've got a subscription of the month club. These just show up at your house every day. Kick the can. You don't need the fucking can anymore. And it actually tastes good. It goes in every single liquid available. Waters, beers, Kool-Aids, liquors, you name it. And they ship everywhere in the entire world, which is amazing. Because United doesn't ship everywhere in the entire world.
Yeah.
StrikeForceEnergy.com does. Go to StrikeForceEnergy.com, type in the promo code REVOLUTION, you get 20% off. Last but not least, we've got At Night She Cries While He Rides the Steed. Jables. There's the horse noise we were looking for.
That was like horse into like a bear.
It sounded like a horse was on acid.
Yeah.
Strong, like blotter acid. Right in the eyes. You're going right in the eyes with that acid.
Yeah.
You're not going tongue. You're not going sugar cube. You're going blotter acid right into the fucking eyes.
That horse was really weird.
Horse was dying. Is this book the greatest of this or any generation? Yes. Will they keep it locked away in a safe for the rest of mankind in case apocalypse happens? Probably. Because this has got to live on forever. I wrote it. I also did the Audible. You can go to Amazon.com, Walmart.com, every.com and get the fucking book. Or it's in bookstores everywhere. Your choice. But today.
Okay, here we go.
I almost feel like I should stretch. Like I should stretch out. Like I should have an Asian masseuse behind me today.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Yeah. They pulled an Asian man off a plane. So I think I should have an Asian masseuse today for this warm up.
All right. So break it down. What?
Here's the thing. So in case you live under a rock, or maybe somebody was in surgery in your life and you haven't seen this story, because this has dominated the news cycle for the last 24 hours now. An Asian man in his 60s, he was a doctor, was on a flight from Chicago. So he was going from O'Hare to Lexington, Kentucky. Yeah. Yeah.
First of all.
Yeah. First of all, should have stayed in Chicago.
Secondly,
if you are United Airlines and you're pulling people off a flight to Lexington, Kentucky, what the fuck is happening?
Let him
anymore?
Go to Lexington.
Yeah. Let anyone go to Lexington, Kentucky. Like, so what happened was, you know, they overbook these flights now. And the reason why I'm going to rage against this today is because this has happened to me. So what they're doing now is they're overbooking flights, and the airline is saying, United is saying, this is a necessity for airlines due to different levels of no-show passengers experienced on different routes.
I find that really hard to believe.
So do I. It's normally a highly sophisticated process based on extensive, detailed statistical analysis. That's what John Strickland said. He's an aviation expert, director at JSL Counseling. First of all, John, it's bullshit. It is. And I'll tell you exactly what's happening and why this is going on. So this Asian man gets on the plane. They get on. They said they need four volunteers to get off the plane. They are overbooked, and they have four people. The airlines claim that they were crew members of United who needed these seats, and then in order for the Lexington flights to take off on time, they needed four normal passengers to get off, and they were going to put you on a flight the next day and give you $800 to do so. Mm-mm. Which, if you're, you know, most of the time you're traveling, it's for business, you know, nobody on every single flight is going for vacation every single goddamn time.
No.
So chances are you book this flight to get to your destination at a certain time because you need to be there at a certain time.
Yeah.
Or because of price range. Four people didn't get up. They didn't give up their seats on the plane. Therefore, United Airlines said, great, at random, and I'm using air quotes, and I never use air quotes. At random.
You hate air quotes.
Hate fucking air quotes. At random, we're gonna choose four people and take them off the flight. This Asian doctor was one of them. He said, no, I don't want to go. I paid for this seat. I need to be on this flight. I'm a doctor. I've got to do things on patients the next day. I don't even know if that's true or false yet. They haven't got to the bottom
Doesn't
of that.
Doesn't fucking matter.
Doesn't fucking matter. He paid for the seat just like everyone else, and he's getting ripped off the flight. Literally ripped off the flight. So they bring on a plane's clothes, I guess you would call him a security officer for United Airlines.
Probably a marshal, right?
And he looked like Debo from Friday. Huge fucking dude. And they rip this 60-year-old Asian man off the plane. In the process, his head bangs off one of the armrests. Blood's pouring out of his nose and his mouth. And they're dragging this motherfucker off the plane. Somehow, he breaks away from security and is able to get back on the plane. And clearly, he's dazed at this point. Like, right. I would say it looked like a concussion based on the video that I saw. And he's just muttering to himself, I just want you to kill me. I just want you to kill me. I just want you to kill me. And he's muttering this like four or five times. And there's, in this day and age, you've got multiple people with camera phones who videotape this whole thing. I mean, they ripped this motherfucker out of his seats, drug him down the aisles and off the plane in front of the whole entire plane. And the passengers are screaming at security to stop doing this.
I mean,
and they don't stop it. They don't let up. Now, what's happening during all of this is at home, for those of you at home, when you're thinking, oh, they choose you at random, they don't choose you at random. If you buy your tickets off of Orbitz, Expedia, Kayak, any fucking site like that, mm-hmm. You're paying a cheaper fare.
Yeah.
So that's what they're starting with. This isn't a highly complex, extensive, detailed statistical analysis. Bullshit. They're taking the people who are medallion members or bullion members or whatever the fuck they're calling it to barter with, of like, oh no, this is a this is a glitter member, this is a sparkle member, or you know, the gold level, your silver, your platinum, your whatever fucking periodic charts, goddamn, oh, the copper member, whatever you are in the periodic chart of your fucking bullshit airline pass, they're not pulling those people off. They're pulling off the people who are trying to get a flight, you know, cheaper by going through Expedia, or they're pricing out other shit because they want you to go to their website and their website only, like United.
Mm-hmm.
And you think you're getting, when you pop up on United and you order a ticket, let's say from Chicago to Lexington, and you go on there and they're like, great, we can get you on that flight. It's going to be $400. Then you're like, okay, $400.
I ordered it late. Fine, whatever.
Kind of sounds reasonable.
Yeah.
But then when you start clicking, immediately And this is all the websites. This isn't just United, by the way. So I don't want to feel like I'm just singling them out, because this is Delta. This is American Airlines. This is United now. The only one this doesn't happen on, shockingly, and I fly a lot. I fly so all
Southwest.
The time. Southwest.
Yeah.
And everybody says Southwest is the shittiest. But we live on the East Coast. We don't get to fly Southwest. Yeah. So what happens is when you get there, you're like, all right, $400. And then they're like, great, sir. Would you like a comfort seat that's guaranteed for $39? And you're like, no, I don't want to add to my shit. And then they're like, oh, okay, great. Well, then the only seats available are like rows 30 through fucking 94 right. in the back of the plane.
Which is fine if it's guaranteed.
Which is fine if it's guaranteed.
Yeah.
No big deal.
Yeah.
Who gives a baker's fuck? Yeah. All right, fine. You want me to sit in row 98? Whatever.
Yeah.
Couple hour flight, like Chicago to Lexington.
Sure.
No big deal.
Yeah, I'm already going to Lexington.
No,
I'm just joking.
Yeah. And one, sure, and one would people. Say, hey, Ross, why don't you fly in first class? I can't justify throwing an extra grand at first class. If it's a 2 hour flight or an hour and a half flight, it's like, what the fuck do I really care? Mm-hmm. Like, if I'm going one way, what do I care?
Yeah.
And if you're going super long, then yeah, I try to do it. I try to upgrade. But on a short flight like that, I don't do it because it's like, what's the fucking point? I don't throw an extra grand for an hour and a half of what? Two fucking free drinks, two screwdrivers, you know, and like boiled peanuts, like an extra, you know, they're not the other peanuts. These are boiled straight from the South. Well, we got them right in our plane.
They're warm peanuts and like the warm nuts.
Yeah, they're warm nuts.
And they're really great.
They are great.
Amazing.
But for an hour and a half, like I can hold off on the warm nuts. Maybe sure, I'll grab a bag of combos. So then you go, you click on, you're like, great. I'm going to sit in seat fucking 93. Click on for the next flight, your return flight. Oh, hi, sir. That time you wanted, you know, all of the times that you want now are now blocked off and you have to pay extra for. And those times, other than 6 a.m. or at midnight, this is what they're doing with it now. They're like, oh, if you want any other flight that's not 6 a.m. or midnight, you're going to have to pay an extra $78.
Jesus.
Yeah. So then you're like, all right, fuck, I guess it's $78. And you click that on because you don't want to get up. You don't want to drive to the airport at fucking 3 a.m.
No.
You also don't want that midnight flight that doesn't get you home to your family
right.
at fucking 6 a.m. the following day where you're like, what am I going to tell my wife to wake up and come get me with the kids? They got school. They got a lot of shit going on.
Mm-hmm.
So then you're like, all right, I guess I'll pay the extra $78 and I'll get the flight that I need so I can get back in time or whatever. Then it goes to choose your seats again. Choose those fucking seats. All we have are middle seats, but again, you can upgrade for another $39.
Mm-hmm.
You can get a guaranteed seat in rows 15 or higher. Wouldn't that be nice? You get 2 extra inches of comfort. It's like 2 extra fucking inches of comfort for an extra $39. Or it'll only show you that they've got middle seats in rows 36 through 90 fucking 3. And it's like, hey, motherfucker, I already paid $78 to try to get the right time on the flight that I wanted. Now I'm going to be on a middle seat in row 38 through 93.
Mm-hmm.
So by the time you get to the end of all this fuckery, that $400 flight that you ordered, it's now up to $600.
Right.
And that's what you're doing when you go through their websites. However, if you go to Orbitz and Expedia and all that other shit,
it's just the price.
It's just the price that it is. They give you the option to upgrade, but they're going to get you on the flight you wanted. However, the flight isn't guaranteed. Your seat is not guaranteed. And what they
so
do
when
now,
you close out, it says your seat is not guaranteed.
It says, hey, your seat isn't guaranteed. You get it when you check in. They're going to give it to you when you check in.
Mm.
And you're like, oh, all right, because it charged my credit card. So you're like, I have a guaranteed seat on this flight.
Sure.
I'm definitely going to be on this flight.
No,
you're not. You're not. And I learned this the hard way. I have to take a lot of last minute flights. I went to the NFC Championship game to watch my beloved Atlanta Falcons play. But it was last minute. Obviously, they won the week before. I didn't know they were getting into the game. Mm-hmm. So I got the ticket the following day, and it was about 6 days in advance.
Right.
And I got it through fucking, I believe it was Delta. I got it through Delta. And so I show up to the gates, and mind you, I had to be in another, I had to be back to work on Monday. So I was only flying in for the day, and I was going to fly out right after the game. And I just went to Orbitz and tried to grab any, you know, flight that I could. Cheapest flight, big deal. From Wilmington to Atlanta, 45-minute flight. Who gives a shit? Put me in row 93. I don't give a fuck. Right, I'm going to the game. It's a 45-minute flight. Yeah, don't care. I get to the gates when I check in, and I was like, hi, I don't have a – still don't have a seat yet. You know, I put my card in the machine, and I'm, you know – and I didn't fly.
Those fucking things.
Yeah. Don't even get me started on those goddamn things fucking work when you show up there. Oh, check in yourself. Just slide your card in the fucking thing and we'll fucking find you.
And then you go to the counter and you're like, well, can I just talk to a human?
No,
you need to go back to the computer, check in there. Obviously, they're grooming us to only use the computers. But I'm like, yeah, but... Yeah. You're here. You're right here.
But here's the thing. The computer never recognizes your shit. Then you end up having to type in the Da Vinci code for your flight. Oh, what's your destination city? What's your flight number? What's your fucking thing? If I knew all of that shit,
I
would be Russell Crowe in A Beautiful Mind, or I'd print out the whole goddamn itinerary and pin it to my shirt like I was a kindergartner explaining to the teacher what allergies I had.
Right.
Don't give me peanuts. Mm-hmm. I'm allergic to peanuts, soy, fucking fructose, whatever. Because that's the way we're being treated now, like we're some little children with this whole fucking game.
Definitely in airplanes. Like, that's the last place where you really get herded and treated like...
Children. I don't even know if herded's a word.
Hoarded?
Herded?
Herded?
Oh, herded, like cows. Like, yeah.
Is that a word?
Yeah, I think we'll go with it. If not, we'll throw the ED
anyways,
on there.
Herd you in, and you're treated like children. Can you please put on your little seatbelt for no reason? Can you please turn off your phone for no reason? Can we please just put your seat back up? Why?
Oh, the baggage. And the baggage. It's like, oh, we don't have enough room. We never have enough room.
We won't go down that road. But
and
you
here's
know,
the road
the
we're going
place.
Down. So they were like, no, sir, when you go through security, you're going to want to go to the gates and get your seat assignment. And I was like, all right, but I'm right here right now. You can't just give me a seat aside. Oh, no. We can't do that. So the gate does that. The gate does that for you. And I was like, all right. It seemed kind of weird. So I go up to the gate at Delta.
Yeah.
And they were like, oh, sir, we're not sure if you're going to have a seat on this flight. And I was like, I'm sorry? That's when it starts going off in my mind. Rally around the family with a pocket full of shells. And
right
I was
away.
Like, wait, what? And they were like, well, the flight might be overbooked. Same as this Asian man. And I was like, okay, the flight might be overbooked. That's great. But
I'm
I bought
here.
A ticket. Here's my itinerary. Here's my credit card statement that I paid for this. What do you mean it might be overbooked? Well, you know, some passengers might not get on. Great. Who are they? You might be one of them, they said. And I was like, I'm sorry? And I was flying in to go to the NFC Championship. There's no other flights. Flying to Atlanta for the game. Tickets are crazy expensive to go to the game. And I fucking lost it. So they bring out this packet. They were like, and actually, sir, we're going to need you to sign something, a release. And I was like, what?
No, sir.
Yeah. So they print out, Delta prints out this, it was about 6 or 7 pages worth of shit. And I had to sign it. And I'm reading it as I'm signing this. And it's saying, if for whatever reason we decide to remove you from this flight, we're going to give you X amount of dollars and put you on another flight.
What if you don't sign it?
That's what I said.
Okay.
So I said, I don't want to sign this. And they said, you have to. You've got to sign this.
Or else.
Or else we're not going to give you a seat. And we're not even going to put you on this plane or give you the possibility of being on this plane. And this is a normal flight I booked off of Orbitz. Booked off Orbitz a million times because it's fucking easy.
Orbitz lives matter.
Yeah. So what I said to her at the gate was, I was like, look, if I don't get on this plane, there's going to be a fucking problem. She was like, what do you mean, sir? And I'm like, I'm telling you, you're going to have to call the fucking police and physically remove me from this this plane. I was like, I have tickets to the NFC Championship. It's a once in a lifetime thing. And it literally is. It's only happened once in my lifetime. Yeah. And I go, you're going to have to physically remove me from this fucking plane if there's a problem with this. Because I've never had to sign a 6-page thing for tickets I bought on a flight. And the look on her face and the other dude that was standing there was like, oh, fuck. And they were like, well, your number, I was like, number 8 to get on. And I was like, why am I number 8? I'm not flying on standby. I bought a ticket 6 days in advance. Why am I number 8? And I was like, I don't give a shit whatever you have to do. You put me on this fucking flight, or there's going to be, or I'm getting on the flight and you're going to have to call the police to get me off. And I can promise you, this whole shit's going to be fucking delayed for a long goddamn time. Magically, so I had to wait for everybody else to board. And then magically, one of the standby people, I was first instead of 8 of whatever this fake fucking list of shit there was.
Sure.
And I got on the flight. So this whole time, you know, for like 30 minutes before, I'm panicking because I'm like, shit, am I going to have to rent a car to get there?
Yeah.
I'm definitely getting on this plane. I know the police are going to come.
Right.
Where am I going to be watching this game? Because I'm pretty sure it's going to be from jail. At this point.
Yeah.
So I get on.
Do they have TVs there? Are they HD? Like what?
Totally. And I'm anxious as fuck. But I get on. Flight goes. And I make the game. Whatever. This Asian man did not make this thing. I don't know if he had patience the next day. He said he did. He didn't make his plane. And you're like, all right. Well, maybe this was a one-off situation. Mm-hmm. Maybe, you know, maybe they changed the rules. Or maybe something really fucked up happens. After that, the next week I'd fly to Salt Lake City for business. The same exact thing happened, only this time, it was for work and somebody bought me a first class ticket. Then you get on right away. Everything is fine.
Sure.
But I saw a woman get pulled off this flight. They stopped the plane and it was, it was a connector to go back to Wilmington and it was late and it was like 10. And the flight wasn't getting until 11:30. And you know there's no other flights that night. She's staying in Atlanta.
Yeah.
She's staying in Atlanta for this because it was Salt Lake City to Atlanta. And she's staying there overnight. And they pulled her off the plane.
Did they have to pull her too?
Well, here's the thing. The plane was grounded. And they get on and they said, we're sorry, everybody. This flight has been grounded. We need to gas up. We need to refuel the plane. And I looked at the woman next to me, who is some super snooty fucking, champagne flute, like just a bitch. Just an all bitch. And that's fine. I don't give a shit.
Sure.
And she looks over and I go, hey, does this seem strange to you? And she was like, no. They're gassing the plane. They just said they're gassing the plane.
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, but I
trying to have a real moment with her.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Trying to have a real moment with a person on a plane.
No. That's what they said.
Yeah, they're gassing the plane. So I'm like, but can you? I was like, I don't see a tank. I don't see anybody filling up the plane on this side. And I was like, do you see anybody on the? And I looked out the other windows. I was like, do you guys see anybody filling up a gas tank on the other side? And the other people were like, no, I don't see a tank. And I was like, why are we sitting here then? And we just kept sitting there for 45 minutes. Then all of a sudden, a woman comes on the plane with a list. I mean, it was old school.
That happened when I was on the plane before, too. We were together, and we were both like, what is happening?
Yeah, but this one, this was a Schindler's List. They were looking for motherfuckers to pull off this plane.
Same.
So anyways, they get on the plane, and they were like, we think we've made a mistake, and somebody might be on the plane who shouldn't be on the plane. So they start calling one by one. They duck goosed us dead serious down the thing. We had to go over our name, who we were, the whole shit. And then they get to this one woman and they were like, actually, when we called for volunteers, did you not hear your name called or whatever? And she was like, well, you know, that was 45 minutes ago. Like the flight was supposed to have left. There was nobody there. Clearly there's an empty seat and they're like, oh my gosh, we're so sorry. But you're going to have to leave this plane. And she was attractive. This wasn't a, 60-year-old Asian man. It was an attractive woman where you're like, whoa, this never happens.
Right.
What the fuck?
If you're going to make someone stay in Atlanta overnight, it's usually
you don't make
be
somebody
dude.
Attractive. Yeah.
You're like not an attractive send some lady
woman.
Out.
Yeah, because let's be honest. In the world, there's nothing worse than when a supermodel dies. You know what I'm saying? Like, so
sad.
It's so sad. Like that's
she was so pretty.
Yes, and this girl was so. Anyway, I took a picture of her getting taken off the plane because I'm pissed off that I've got, and I know what's going on now at this point because this happened to me on the flight out.
You're like, oh shit,
and I'm like, oh shit, this is going down, and they're pulling somebody off this fucking plane.
Right.
So I took a picture of her, and since I knew they were probably going to stick somebody else on the plane, I kept firing away on Twitter. With just a picture of this woman, and you know, I was like, why did Delta pull this attractive woman off the plane? I'm in tears. A lot of people around me are sad. We're writing letters to our senator. And you know, at this point, it was more or less like for my own like humor and my own like,
right.
oh shit, this is gonna be a fun thing because I know I'm gonna be delayed. Then I see this guy get on the plane and take her seat. And so they were like, all right, great. Thanks, everybody. Sorry for the mix-up. The plane's now all gassed up and like, ready to go. And it was like, nobody gassed this motherfucker.
Mm-mm. Like, we've gotten rid of the riffraff. Don't worry, everyone.
Yeah. Anyways, this guy gets on. And as the flight takes off, I was like, hey, man. I was like, just out of curiosity. Because he was like a row in front of me or right by me. And I was just like, hey. Just out of curiosity, because this has never happened before.
So
no one's
nosy.
Ever stopped a plane for me before. No one's ever stopped a plane and been like, oh, what? Wait, we've got to wait for
get
this one passenger.
Get him on here.
Yeah, yeah. And I was like, how did you get on? Like, that's pretty crazy. And he was like, oh, man. He's like, I'm like a gold level medallion member. And he was just like, man, and he jokingly, like he was a cool guy. He was just like jokingly. It was like, I guess the fucking commercials are true. Like the membership does have its privileges. And I was like, what?
Gross.
What the fuck? And like, but he was joking, and obviously, like, he didn't.
So he didn't see what was happening.
No,
he didn't see that
because wasn't on the plane. No, so he didn't.
Yeah, but he was waiting to get on.
No, but was he waiting to get on from a connecting flight? And he wasn't there when they were holding this. Like, I don't have the answer for. So anyway, somebody had told him afterwards, after my conversation, the person next to you, they were like, yeah, they actually took a woman off who had it was sitting in
had
your
a
seat.
Ticket.
Yeah, yeah, it was sitting in your seat. And he's like, what? And he was genuinely shocked. And he goes, oh, I didn't ask for that. Obviously, I didn't know. And he goes, they just told me, you know, like I ran toward the gate just in case, like, you know, it was late or whatever. And he goes, it was. And he goes, then they had this. They said they had a seat for me.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. So I was like, and I had taken pictures and put this on Twitter. And I was like, holy shit. So when this story popped up with the Asian man, not only did this happen to me, to me personally, but then I had physically seen another woman that this happened to. So after that, I was like, fuck Delta Airlines. I'm not fucking flying Delta. Because
right.
I had another business trip like 2 weeks later after this. So I booked American Airlines.
Which is United, right?
I don't know. Oh. I think they're owned by United now. Like, I don't know.
Okay. We don't want to say that.
Same
yeah.
fucking thing happened to me.
On the American
one. On the American one. Because I like to go through orbits. I like to go through the thing. And then I was like, man. And then again, if you go to the website and add up all the extras and all the fucking things, that 400-hour flight is now, you know, $2,000. And you're like, God damn it, man.
But what it's going to turn into is that you're going to have to pay that to guarantee
yes.
it. So now every time people go, they're like, well, I got a cheap flight. But I might not be able to get on.
And
so
that,
it's like, it's going to
become part
of.
That's what it's turning into. Or is it not? Because of what happened yesterday.
We'll see, I guess. But that's a gnarly thing. And again, you were saying with camera phones, it's like United.
Yeah.
Do you really think that you're getting away with it?
Exactly. There was a million camera phones and all this shit. And even on my Delta flight, which we're going to pop this photo in of this woman who got taken off the plane. Because I saw it happen. And I just, I didn't know until this story, I didn't know this was a thing. And I'm sure a lot of people didn't. This is why I want to talk about this today, because a lot of people travel, a lot of people fly, and you're getting fucked by all of these airlines.
It's a crazy thing.
Yeah, where it's like there's all these fees and all this shit adds up just to guarantee a seat. Not forget comfort at this point.
Right.
Just to guarantee a seat on the flight, where it's like, hey, motherfuckers, this isn't StubHub. Don't tell me that something is $200 and when I check out, it's $900. Like, just put the correct price on there. Something should be done
Are they trying to keep us like provincial? Are they trying to keep us like in our little areas and like no?
That's what it feels
and
like.
Basically, the only people that are able to go in between are like really rich. It's the whole plane is going to be first class, basically, because you guarantee it.
Half of it,
and you're going to be paying $2,000.
Yes. Yeah, but because right point. Now, if you go to anybody's website at all, including Southwest, go to Southwest, go to Delta, go to American Airlines or United or whatever the fuck it's called. Mm-hmm. Go to any of those websites, type in a flight, and then the return flight of what you want home. You're going to be in a fucking middle seat in the back. They're going to say they have no aisles or windows. They're going to make you pay for that. You will not even see the front of the plane. You can forget about it. If you want to even see the front of a plane, you better buy a fucking model airplane and take it with you, because that's as close as you'll be seeing the front of the plane.
Yeah.
And then just add it up. Just go to any of these websites, type in when you want to go, relative times. I'm not saying do it like overnight. Like, look, if you try to get a ticket overnight, obviously it's going to be higher. But try to book something out in a month in advance. And each one of these websites is going to tell you personally, we are booked. And you're like, man, that's weird. No one's going to fucking Fresno, California. And why can I only get a middle seat in the back of the plane that's not guaranteed unless I pay an extra $90 to be upgraded? You're going to tell me that 2 months from now, Fresno's such a hot town that I gotta upgrade with 90 upgrades to guarantee myself a ticket on the plane? And it's bullshit.
It's so, such in-your-face classist, too. Like,
it is.
With that, with just first class, let's just say. It's just so in your face of like, move to the back, peasant. And it's very much like everyone knows.
There are Rosa Parks and everybody up in that motherfucker.
Well, you very much know how much everybody not has, but like how much they paid, how much they afford it. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
when
yeah.
you're looking at 100%, the rows, at yes. the people. And now when you see people getting taken off, which is going to, I don't know if it's going to happen more or less, but now you know
less, yeah.
that person is at the very bottom, right?
Yeah.
So it's like,
they got their tickets on Orbitz or Expedia or this other thing. Because here's the thing.
It's
not because you're poor or richer or whatever. It is out of complete convenience that you go to a third-party website like Expedia or Orbitz, because they line it up for you
and
they say...
And you see everything.
Yes. And you see all the airlines in one. They give you all the times.
Yeah.
It is purely out of convenience where you're like, great, this is why I go to these sites, because they're going to tell me what all of this shit is from all these other airlines all in one spot, and I don't have to go anywhere else.
Right.
And that's why you do it. Yes. It's not because you're fucking poor.
No.
But
I'm just saying, like,
you now, but that's what you're going to think now when you see people on planes or standby, these weird lists, or they ask you to sign something.
Like, no, I have a ticket.
When I had to sign that shit at Delta, it was scary. I mean, to me, I was like, all right, you're now making me, and the form, because the forms were so long that you couldn't physically, you would have to stand there for probably,
and your flight would be taken off by the time you
by the time you physically read them yourself. You're not a and you're not a fucking lawyer. You don't know what all this shit means, and you're asking for 18 signatures on this shit. And they were like, oh, you know, but we're gonna give you this fucking thing, and it's just like, no, you're not.
You definitely aren't.
And I was like, man, this can't be real. This can't be real. Like, but again, if this could happen to me, this could literally happen to anyone. I mean, it's fucking crazy.
Yeah,
it's absolutely fucking crazy. Like, so this poor Asian man is us right now, and I think the outrage and everything that's going on right now is because he represents everybody who's flying and every, you know,
and
facet
seeing
of life.
All these weird little things that are happening, and we're kind of just going along with it. And this,
in
yes,
life.
Definitely represents someone being like, I'm not fucking getting off the plane.
Yeah.
You can beat me up. You can fucking bloody my nose, but I'm staying.
I believe this is when he got back on the plane, John. Let's listen and then we'll talk about it.
Pilots drive the plane. Can't they rent a car for the pilots and have them drive?
Ah!
My God! Guys, my God! What are you doing?
And I'm not, and like, good for him. I mean, this dude, 60, and was like, fight the power. I'm coming back on.
All right.
He's just mumbling, just kill me.
Just kill me. That was a little bit weird.
But. Look, if you've been knocked unconscious, though, shit, by some huge man. Yeah. Look, if you saw the amount of blood, he was ready. He was ready to go to the other side. He was just like, fuck it. I'm ready to die.
That's the weird part of it for me. Just kill me. That's hard. That's hard.
But if you were knocked unconscious, you don't know what the fuck you're saying. I mean, his glasses were smashed. He's all fucked up and bleeding everywhere. Like, yeah, just kill. He probably thought he was being killed.
he thought it was like a torture tube.
250-pound, 6'5" dude gets on the plane and physically rips you out of your seat, drags you down the aisles. I'm talking like a little kid. His arms were up. He was getting dragged by his arms. His shirt was up, you know. He's exposed and he's getting drugged down the aisles.
Okay.
That's a little much. You're probably like, fuck, kill me. Yeah, kill me at this point.
I hear you. I'd want to.
Because now he's everywhere all over the internet, bloodied, shit all fucked up, tummy hanging out. And then United Airlines puts up this bullshit tweet yesterday.
Please, what does it say?
Let me pull this up here because it was a real beaut.
They put it up right after, or?
Yeah.
Okay. In response to the whole world being like, fuck you, United.
Everybody was like, hey.
So what'd they say?
Here was United's response to this. This is an upsetting event to all of us here at United. I apologize for having to reaccommodate these customers. That's what bothers me, by the way.
Reaccommodate. Don't fucking throw that shit at me.
Yeah. Our team is moving with a sense of urgency to work with the authorities and conduct our own detailed review of what happened. We are also reaching out to this passenger to talk to him directly and further address and resolve this situation. And then it says, this is from Oscar Munoz, CEO of United Airlines. First of all, Oscar, let me break this down to you on that last sentence. Sure. We are also reaching out to this passenger to talk to him directly and further address and resolve this situation. What we're going
to
do is throw a shit ton of money at this guy to settle. So this doesn't have to be drug out in court. So you might as well.
He should.
Just go ahead and say that to him, because I don't know what dollar amount it is. I'm going to guess, though, it's going to be at least seven figures.
Yeah, his lawyer will definitely.
The other thing that everybody is just railing on United is this reaccommodating of these customers. You're accommodating people by charging them to get on your plane.
Then reaccommodate.
You're not reaccommodating anybody by dragging them off a fucking flight of where they're supposed to go. That's the whole point of flying. You're flying to get to somewhere quicker than you could in a car, on a bicycle, on a skateboard, or on a fucking Razor scooter. So you're not reaccommodating anyone. You're reaccommodating yourself is what you're doing because you're trying to reaccommodate your customers who have the gold bullion level of bullshit. So hopefully they'll keep flying more and spending money. You're not reaccommodating the 60-year-old Asian man who you drugged down the aisles. You want to reaccommodate him. You're going to have to go through the law offices of Bain and Rodzik or whoever the fuck
Preach.
He's. Because you know everybody and their mother's calling in. Johnny Cochran right now
is
asking Jesus for a phone from heaven to be like, please let me call down right now and get this motherfucker
let
on the phone.
Let me get this fucker. Oh, my God.
Jose Baez, who's repping Aaron Hernandez and the double murders, is like, hold my beer, Aaron. Wait. Hold my fucking beer. Let me make one quick call. Because you know even the judge in that case is like, oh, fuck. Hey, Baez, you want to go ahead and adjourn or whatever the fuck it is for like 15 minutes?
Yourself?
I know. Yeah. I know you got to make a call. And that's right now.
Oh, yeah.
But this shit is happening.
What was the first thing that I said after?
Of what?
After I heard this story.
What did you say?
I said, well, our flight's going to be pretty cheap now. Like,
United? Yeah.
Should we go?
This
somewhere?
Is probably, if you're going to book a United flight, this is the day to do it.
I think it's the dirt.
Yeah. Yeah. It's this is the day to go ahead and book that shit.
That was a mean thing, but I did. That's the first. I just
first thoughts
before I saw the pictures. First thoughts. Before the thing, I thought, we can get a cheap.
You can definitely get on, and I think you might be able to it get in the be. First 15 rows. Oh,
I know, guaranteed. No extra fees.
You might get an aisle seat. You look like a tall drink of water. You might get an aisle seat.
I want guarantees, United.
Yeah, yeah. And again, like all this shit is happening in all facets of life. Mm. Bank of America. I've been sending these tweets. Like I'm a verified person, which means you're super important because they put a blue check mark next to your name on social mm-hmm. media. But I will say what I like it for. Whenever there's a customer service problem, I just go right there and they hit me back immediately.
Sure.
Bank of America, who's my fucking bank. Every time I call customer service there, the last one was the worst. They were like, sorry, sir, you're going to, the average wait time is 1 hour, 31 minutes to 2 hours, 17 minutes. Physically drove into the branch and I was like, hey, are you aware this is going on? And another time they had me on hold for like, I think it was 1 hour and 6 minutes, and I posted it like a screenshot of it.
Yeah.
And I said, hey guys, just so you know, the guy who won the marathon at the 2016 Olympic Games, we're now almost halfway past his time at this point of whatever. And like they immediately, oh my God, so we're so sorry. Please hit us back directly. And I was like, fuck you guys.
Answer.
So I went into the branch. The other latest and greatest is Time Warner Cable, because where we live, didn't have a choice but to get them for internet.
Yeah.
I don't use them for cable because it's fucking $50,000 a month.
Mm-hmm.
We got them for internet. They got purchased, or they either bought Charter or got purchased by Charter Communications, which then all of them got purchased by Spectrum.
Yeah, yeah.
Internet at the other house. Yeah, yeah. We have no one else to call because that's the only one in our area who does it. But I can't get any help, and I can't get anybody out to the house.
Right.
Because they're like, oh, my God, sorry. We've been purchased by somebody else. Let me throw you on this other call. Oh, I'm sorry. So we've been purchased by somebody else. Let me throw you on this other call.
It's like trying to talk someone during a 19 divorce.
Fucking phone calls. Yeah. You're just like, Jesus Christ. Like, at this point, I'm gonna buy two fucking tin cans and a string and just try to tie it to the telephone pole myself and try to get internet. Because that's... that's how frustrated you are with all of this shit that's going on. But I want to say good on the Chinese man, the Asian man who fought the fucking power.
I love it.
And said, you're gonna have to buckle me out. I can't do that on the phone with customer service. You can do it in person now because there's too many camera phones. So if you want to fight the power, fight the fucking power. That's what I say.
Yeah.
You can't do it through customer service, and that's why they're hoping that you can just go through robots. So no human ever has to deal with you. Mm-hmm. Nothing will ever get out. There's no footage or video or anything else.
Mm-hmm.
And then, luckily everybody had a camera phone and Oscar Munoz from American Airlines.
Hey, Oscar.
Hey, Oscar, we're re-accommodating you. We're going to fucking reach out to you directly to deal with your lawyer. I'm happy all this shit happened because it's like, again, happened to me.
Let's bring it back a little bit. Let's bring back humans.
Let's bring back some customer service. Let's bring back some friendliness. Let's start treating people better.
Don't make me pay for my bag either.
Shit bags. I know.
So that people are shoving their big, huge, because they don't want to pay the extra money because they already paid 50 other extra
exactly.
things. So they're trying to shove this big fucking duffel bag up there. And you're like, if you would just check it for me.
Yeah.
We could get on. No delays. No fucking shit. Like, let's.
And don't even get me started at like paying the extra money at the thing. And then you get on the plane and they're like, oh, all of our overhead space is taken.
Yeah.
We'll check your bags for free. And it was like, motherfucker, I just paid
$80
to check you at the front.
Should we just start like rolling our big, huge bags up there?
That's what I feel like. Just pushing it through and be like,
you want to do it for free now?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, whatever. But. Oh, they won't let it through the fucking thing.
They won't.
Security. I think maybe we fly a little bit too much and we're getting like super heated about it. But I'm just saying, I fly a lot.
We fly a lot for
work.
We
have to.
Have to fly.
I think maybe, Some people will understand.
Some friend of ours, one of our beef fries, Brandon and Hannah, who were on the show a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
They took a train from LA to Atlanta. I was like, Why are you taking that train? Maybe they got sick. Yeah. Now we know.
Now we know. They're guaranteed to get there.
Boy, on what the day. Fuck? Well, you kind of. Yeah. kind of.
A lot more.
Kind of, yeah.
A lot more guaranteed, yeah. I guess. I guess,
you know, take a unicycle to whatever your destination
and
is now.
You'll be more of a guarantee.
So you don't get butt fucked.
Because
they're just trying to spread your cheeks. They're not even putting a dick or a fist in. They're trying to put their whole head inside your asshole now.
Right.
And just wear you out.
I think my point was that some people are going to be like, what the fuck are you guys talking about? And then others that have to fly for the shit all the time. But
I think people will get it now.
Yeah, no, no.
I think people will get it now that they've seen it. I've talked about it. I've explained my experiences because this is going on. And I think yesterday's thing was the first example where you actually saw it. And now a bunch of people are just figuring it out of like, hey, man, this happened to me.
Yeah.
Like,
and I was saying to you, too, it's happened to us on this flight. And it was the same thing. They were just like going down this list, and you and I finally asked the lady, we're just like, what is going on?
What is this
on?
Schindler's List?
And she was just like, oh, somebody's just not in the right seat. You know, they give you that, whatever.
They give
I would
you this
love
weird
to talk to a flight attendant or whatever and find out, like, what
the
they
real
tell
deets.
Them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The real like, details
I'm sure
of
they
it.
Won't tell you, but it'd be crazy to know.
Look, we're at the point in the show where it's the revolutionary figure of the week. I was fucking hot today. Forgive me.
It was your show. It was definitely.
Fuck.
Yeah, I'm back, guys.
Yeah.
Jesse's back.
I just.
It's not this show.
Boy, because I just can't stand shit like that. Like, everybody is paying for shit. Like, money, I don't, rich or poor in this life, money's fucking hard to come by. Like,
yeah,
if you bought something, you should be able to get what you bought. That's the way I feel. This, in this week's revolutionary figure of the week, actually goes to two American brothers. They're inventors and they were aviation pioneers.
Oh boy.
They were the fucking Wright brothers who built the first goddamn plane. Did they charge anybody? No. Did they charge you bag fees? Absolutely not. Did you always have a window seat? You bet, because there was no fucking windows on the goddamn plane. The Wrights brothers.
I think the idea is this is not what the Wrights brothers had in mind.
No, not at all. You think the Wright brothers had bag fees? Window, aisle seats, middles, first class, economy, business class, tucked away next to the bathroom. You think they had any of that shit in mind? You think they took a fucking hot bag of peanuts on their flights? No. No, they didn't. They were just trying to get from A to B, hop, skip, and a jump, literally, because that motherfucker barely got off the ground. But they got there. And they didn't fuck anybody over or overcharge anybody. So to the Wright brothers I'm talking about Orville and Wilbur. Bless your hearts, RIP, and stay vigilant out there, America. Just try not to get fucked in your day-to-day life is what I'm telling you. For Jesse Wiseman, a.k.a. Jables, I am Ross Patterson. This is the revolution. Revolt, everybody. Fight the power. Don't let somebody rip you out of your fucking seat at the end of the day. Good night, everybody, and good day. Fly safely.
Bye.
Fly safely.